producer's equilibrium is a condition. Producer equilibrium is a situation where producer get maximum production from his fixed income. Maximum production from his fixed income. And therefore, producer's equilibrium is established at a point where two conditions are satisfied. Number one, ISO-cost line is tangent to ISO-quant. ISO-cost line is tangent to ISO-quant. Second condition, that at the point of tangency, ISO-quant is convex to the origin. If two conditions are satisfied, then producer's equilibrium is obtained. Thus, producer's behavior for maximization of production may be obtained when two conditions are satisfied. Necessary condition, that hectare equal cost line, that is factor cost line, equal factor cost price line, must be tangent to ISO-quant curve. And second condition is known as sufficient condition, that at the point of tangency, ISO-quant must be convex to the origin. If these two conditions are satisfied, then producer's equilibrium is obtained with the help of ISO-quant curve. This analysis is thus similar to consumer's behavior with the help of indifference curve. But one thing is very important. These two analyses are same. Consumer's behavior and producer's behavior analysis is same. Conditions are same. But ISO-quant and indifference curve concepts are different. What is the difference between indifference curve and ISO-quant? Generally it is asked in BPSC examination, UPSC examination. Difference between indifference curve and ISO-quant. First difference, ISO-quant cannot touch axis OX and OY. ISO-quant cannot touch OX axis and OY axis. It means labor and capital cannot be zero. In production, labor capital cannot be zero. Labor must be more than zero. Capital must be more than zero. On the other hand, under indifference curve analysis, indifference curve can touch x axis or can touch y axis in case of monomania, consumer's behavior. Consumer may spend 100% his income on apple, orange remaining zero. He may spend 100% on orange and apple may be zero. So indifference curve can touch x-axis or can touch y-axis. That means in consumer's behavior analysis, x may be zero and y will be 100%. But that is not in case of ISO-quant. At least one lever is necessary. At least one lever is necessary. At least one capital is necessary. Therefore, delta L, that means L is always more than 0, K is more than 0, Second difference between indifference curve and IsoQuant, that indifference curve be related to consumption. Indifference curve be related to consumption. Whereas IsoQuant is related to production. Third difference, that indifference curve, under indifference curve, utility may be compared, but you cannot exactly tell us that how much utility you are deriving. On the other hand, in case of IsoQuant, exact amount of production can be mentioned, 100 kg, 200 kg, 300 kg. This is possible under IsoQuant analysis. So, there is a difference between indifference curve and IsoQuant fundamentally. Obviously, it is both are different concepts, but the necessary condition, sufficient condition, producer's maximization of production or consumer maximization of satisfaction or utility level will be analyzed with the same method of necessary condition and sufficient condition. That's all. Thank you.